Access for Everyone, Breaking Down Digital Barriers for People with Disabilities. Topic 8, Testing When the Screen is Magnified.
We've all been there before. Sometimes you're looking at a web page on your phone and constantly needing to scroll left to right to read everything. Or something just doesn't look right because a bunch of content is blocked by a really big thing overlaying everything else.
This can be really frustrating. It can make online content really difficult for people with low vision, which is why we're going to discuss the need to test pages or apps at the point of reflow.
Reflow display is when different parts of a web page change as you zoom in on a web browser. It's also known as responsive mode or mobile mode because the web page is responding to the changing window size or zoom level and trying to make sure the page makes sense in different proportions and sizes, like going from a laptop screen to your mobile device. You can see appropriate reflow right now on our webpage for our made-up sample university. As I zoom in and out, you can see that all the content displays in a single column, so it's easy to read.
But here's what it looks like on a web page with poor reflow. We have to constantly scroll back and forth, which is pretty frustrating. And then sometimes you come across things where you can't scroll at all. Like this table under the popular programs heading, we can only see 3.5 program names, not all 6 like we're supposed to.
Now, if you have appropriate reflow on your web page, as we do on this site, you'll see that when I zoom in to, say, 200%, the main menu items disappear. Instead of a horizontal navigation bar listing all the topics, we instead have this button on the top right corner with 3 horizontal lines. Think 2 buns and a patty, a hamburger. When I open the hamburger button, I can still navigate to all of the main menu items that were available at 100%.
But David, let's show everybody what happens with a web page with poor reflow. We still have a hamburger, but when I use the Enter key and try to activate the hamburger button, nothing happens. At this point, as a keyboard user, I can't tell if the hamburger button doesn't work or if all the menu items didn't make it over.
So here are 2 main things to remember about reflow. First, you want to make sure your web page is responsive to magnification and different devices. Second, everything on your web page should be accessible via keyboard, even at reflow. To learn more about testing via keyboard, check out our videos on keyboard testing and visual focus indicators. This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov/OCR or email us at OCR@ed.gov.